I'm going to show you my way today of doing repairs to the stitching. Say, for example, you've gotten to the bottom of your quilt and you are done and you roll forward looking at your back and you notice there's a great big bird nest of threads in one area, or it picked up a large piece of lint under the stitches and you can't get it out. Something that requires you to take out some stitches and replace, whether it be on the row you're currently on or back a couple of rows. It really doesn't matter. If you really want it to look nice, this method will help you to get your beginning and ending threads to line up nicely to where you've ripped back those stitches. So what I'm going to show you is currently we have a section of the quilt that I have ripped out. I have rolled the machine to that point and I have the needle sitting on one of the points of the star that I want to restitch. You can usually tell where you are by following the vertical line on here because that's going to generally line up with where it was on the quilt. So we're going to go back to this particular row and we're going to right click and cue it so it's resewable. Then I'm going to scroll in and look for where I currently have my needle positioned. You'll notice there's where my needle is sitting, and I literally will lower the needle down to point to where I want it to stitch, but don't put it clear down into your quilt. That's very dangerous. You can bump the machine and rip your quilt by doing that, but just so it's just pointing to where that stitching is. Well, as you can see, that doesn't quite align with where I'm at right here, so we're going to do a reposition. Always reposition to something very close to where you want to sew. That's where you can get the best results of being able to line things up. So I am right here on this particular star point, so I'm going to scroll all the way in. I'm going to tell it that's where I'm sitting, apply, done, and scroll out a little bit. Now, what I have done is I have ripped back and I have a tie off here and I have a tie off down here. So what's missing is having it sew from here down to that star point, come back, come down to here, and then sew along here. So the first thing I'm going to do is go to split and click on that star point because that's where I want it to start sewing or stop sewing, depending on which direction it's at. So I'm going to hit accept. Then I'm going to go and move my machine . Now I've moved the machine to where it is close to the ending point of what I've ripped out. Notice it's not quite right there. That's why you need to do a little fidgeting here. So I'm going to go ahead and split there and say accept. What this has done is now split out a section of the pattern. If I go to transform, as you can see, I've got this little section that I want to work with. Well, first of all, we're going to go right-click on the other green area because we don't want to sew that and decue it. Whoops, it didn't do it. And decue it. Scroll back out. You'll notice this side is also because we split it out of the middle, so we're going to right-click and decue it. That took that. It also, for some reason, decued that, so we're going to cue that back up. So now we can see where we're going to sew. It's a little hard to tell though which of those are starts and stops. So what I like to do is come in again and do my split, and let's just split that there. And if you highlight it and hit the delete button, that'll go away. And down here, let's also split it, say there, accept that, and highlight that chunk and delete it. Now it makes it very evident that that is the start position and that is the stop position. So I've got my needle currently setting down here where this position was. So what we're going to do is go ahead and hit go. We're going to do our first continue because that will take it to the starting point, which as you can see it did. Now I'm going to walk over to the sew head and only do a pickup. I'm going to hang on to my thread. I'm going to do a pickup. I'm going to pick up those threads and then move the sew head out of the way so I can tell whether or not I'm in alignment with where my ripped out stitches ended. So hang on a second while I do that. Okay, that didn't work. I'm not lined up very well, so I took that pickup, I took it out of the quilt. I'm going to hit stop, and I'm going to hit edit. That puts me back into work with this piece. So what I'm going to do is highlight that particular stitch area and go to ABC. Now what happened was when I went to align the stitches, it was a little bit above where it should be. So I'm simply going to move this down ever so slightly. Try to make this. In fact, if you want to, you could right click and delete, right click and delete, right click and say this is an arc. So you kind of get a, so you can kind of play with that to keep that arced going. All right. So we're ready to test it again. So we're going to say go. It's going to come up and we're going to take continue. Continue is going to go to that starting point. Once again, I'm going to walk over and only do a pickup. Hang on to your thread, do the pickup, hold on to those two threads, and move the sew head away to see if where the stitches are is exactly lined up with where your ripped out stitches are. Hang on a second while I do that. Perfect. That is exactly where I want it to match up on that end. So I'm going to hit stop and I'm going to hit edit because this is lining up now, but we want to make sure that this is lining up. Even though we did the reposition to say start right there, we want to make sure that's where our stitches really are going to start. So I'm going to go to transform, highlight that area, and do a reverse sew. Now it's going to start sewing here. So I'm going to hit go. Okay. Take the first continue to go to the starting point. Now I'm going to walk over and only do a pickup. Hang on to my threads that get picked up and move the sew head out of the way to see if that's in alignment to where I wanted it to be. That lined up perfectly. That is exactly where I want it to be. So while I'm still hanging on to those two pickup threads, I'm going to tell it continue, because even though I pushed it away, continue will bring it back to where I started. So I'm going to hit continue. It's going to go to my starting point and proceed to stitch. Perfect. I have now replaced this section of the quilt and had it completely match up exactly where I wanted it to be here with what I had ripped out, and exactly where I want it to be there where I had ripped it out. Now you can see I got very lucky with it lining up for this the very first time. What I want you to realize is you can repeat the process that we did down here any number of times to be able to get it to where it's perfectly in alignment. You're using the fact that when you tell it continue the first time, it goes to that starting point. You're using the pickup thread to see exactly where that thread is going to be. You can completely repeat the process over and over again until you get it lined up exactly where you want it to be. I hope that was helpful.
Hello, this is Rick Grijalva of Forever in Stitches. Thank you for watching this video that Ruth has prepared. If you are interested in the quality of this video and would like to see others like it, there are some on the website, foreverinstitches.com, as well as in our books. They are self-study workbooks. One is called Advanced Training Autopilot Mach 3, and the other is called Being Creative with Your Mach 3. Again, I hope you enjoyed listening to this class.